this valedictorian speech for Berkeley's first graduating class. Despite tons of procrastinating, whining, and mental breakdowns, we're finally here. I think that deserves a round of applause. Some of us have been here for 7 years, since Berkeley first opened, and some for only 1 year. But we are all proud to have spent one of the most important stages of our lives here at Berkeley. Since the first moment we stepped into Berkeley, we felt a warm welcome and a sense of community that we had never felt anywhere before. During my first year, I was afraid I wouldn't fit in, but that wasn't the case. I was immediately met with compliments of my messy hair, a creepy handshake from Andrew Nones, right over there, and a Chilean new kid who decided to stick around with me right when we first said hi, despite not even knowing that we would be in the same class. On my first day of school, the classes were fine. But the real highlight was when I went to IKEA with all of the other high schoolers who I had just met for the first time to devour 30 hot dogs and a weird concoction of coffee, mustard, ketchup, and tissue paper. This might sound like an unpleasant afternoon, but I knew from that point that this is the kind of community I've always dreamt of. Throughout the years of Berkeley, I've tried so many new things that I would never try before, like being a basketball team, a soccer team, the volleyball team, and the Batman team, or learning how to play the bass and the drums, or singing in public. I would never have had the opportunity to remember 218 digits of pi and want a movie card for it. Totally worth it. And I wouldn't have climbed the roof of the lock-in and getting a silent treatment from Miss Mel because of it. Berkeley has allowed me to unleash my wild side, if I may say so, as well as allowing me to broaden my horizons and to become more mature, somewhat. So if I might give future graduates some advice on how to survive high school, I would advise you to focus on what you have to do. Have a daily dose of coffee if you must. And most importantly, don't forget who you truly are. There will definitely be people who will try to change who you are. And the only thing I can say is listen. Not just to follow what they say blindly, but to learn how to make judgments that will allow you to develop into a better person. And I can assure you that that would be a lifelong journey. For my fellow seniors, I wish you all success in future endeavors, but most importantly, I hope you enjoy every single moment from now on. Our paths may or may not converge, but it doesn't matter, because in the end, we're still a Berkeley family. Furthermore, I couldn't have come this far with the guidance of my family, my teachers, and my friends, and I can't thank you all enough. Thank you for everything. I remember and cherish every single moment I had here, and I'm certain that my fellow seniors will too. And on a final note, journey out.